today's episode, I'm going to be going through my travel tips and tricks. The things that I think are very beneficial to know and to sort of use when traveling. So the first category we're going to talk about is health. My tips and tricks to do with health. Now, when you're traveling, you are going to be flying on a plane for hours at a time, and planes are just big metal tubes of germs. Not only are you going to be surrounded by germs and foreign, I guess, things in the air, but because your body's in a stressful situation, your immune system is going to be weakened as well. So my first trick to do with health is to be taking a vitamin C tablet or an immune boosting vitamin a couple of weeks before you travel. One that I've been using for the past 2 weeks is by Swiss, and it is their Wellmune. This is just an immune boosting vitamin, and I recommend taking these vitamins like anywhere from 2 to 3 weeks before you travel, as well as while you're traveling. The couple of weeks before is going to really boost your immune system going in, and the tablets that you take while you're traveling is just going to support what the immune system that you built up prior to your travel. So I definitely recommend taking like a vitamin C or an immune boosting tablet before you travel. My next health travel tip is this drug, which is called Travelan. Now this is, says it's travel insurance for your belly. It reduces the risk of traveler's diarrhea. Now when you're eating new foods, a new way of eating, your tummy can be quite upset by it, particularly if you're going to places like Asia, Thailand, the Middle East, India. Those sort of different food cuisines can upset your tummy quite a bit. So having just this reassurance of Travelan is really great, because that's just going to stop it before it happens. And that's just going to, you know, you're not going to have to worry about it. You're not going to have to feel upset. Like, you're not going to have to feel like sick or gross, because this guy is going to help you. My next health travel tip is Vicks inhalers. These guys are great. Now, you use these basically when you have a stuffy nose to clear it. Now, I use these for travel because these are actually antibacterial. So I use these, you know, maybe once an hour, every couple of hours, just sniff it while I'm on the plane and get that antibacterial goodness up there as a way to prevent anything from getting in that I don't want to contract at all. I also carry around with me one of these little Medi managers. Now, basically, this is like a little pill organizer, basically, for, I guess, 3 days worth of pills are what people use these for. I like to carry these around in my bag while I travel, and basically in the little tablets, I might put a couple of Panadols, I might put one of my Travelans in here, and just keep that in my bag for that day's worth of exploring. It's so much more compact and easier than taking like a whole box of Panadol or Nurofen or a whole box of the Travelan. It's nice and small, and it's not going to take up space in your bag. My next travel tips and tricks are all around making sure that you keep your sanity. Travel is quite stressful, or it can be at times, and you can lose your shit over the smallest things. So the next couple of tips and tricks that I'm going to show you guys are all about making sure that I don't turn into a crazy person and I keep my shit together. The first one is taking with me a handheld mirror. Now, I like doing makeup, I like making sure I have nice makeup, and I find at times, especially in Europe, that their bathroom mirrors are either like shit and not actually a mirror, or the lighting in the bathroom is really bad, and I wanted to have something more sort of natural lighting. And the reason why I take a handheld mirror, and I can just take this near the window and do my makeup there or my hair. It's also good too if you're sharing a room, your roommate or your flatmate, whoever you're rooming with might be using the bathroom to have a shower or get ready. You also want to get ready, so if you have a mirror, you can do it out in the bathroom. So that's going to be more efficient. It's going to be better lighting if that's something you're interested in. And it's just, this keeps my sanity alive, because I hate using the little mirrors that come in like your powders or your foundations. Like, they're just horrible. So I definitely, this definitely keeps my shit in my head. My next little tip and trick is getting your hands on a headphone splitter. Now, I absolutely lose my shit when I try and use my own headphones on an airplane. Airplanes use a two-prong headphone sort of system, and when you put your single one in there, like, you're not gonna get sound, and you have to sit there, like, pulling out, putting it in, turning it, wiggling it, trying to get that sweet spot where sound is actually gonna come through, and then when that sound actually comes through, like, it's like shit sound. So getting your heads on a headphone splitter is just going to make your single headphone system compatible with a double prong system, and it's this just stops me from being a crazy person. My next tip and trick is about flight times. Now, jet lag is such a big thing, and you know, people tell you lots of different ways to try and overcome jet lag. In my personal experience, the best way that I've overcome jet lag is by arriving in my destination at night time. So for example, I'm flying into Madrid in a 4 days time, and my flight arrives at 9:30 at night. Last year, when I was flying into Italy, my flight arrived at like 8:30 at night. Now, this is so beneficial. You are going to be so exhausted from your travel. You're probably not going to have slept on the plane. You'll be changing flights, carrying suitcases. You're going to be exhausted. So what you're going to do is, when you finally get to your hotel at night time, you're just going to crash in the bed because you are like, haven't slept properly in 24 hours. Now, that's excellent. You've fallen asleep, you've right then and there, you're on Madrid or wherever you are, you're on their time zone. My little tip is that before I go to bed, I make sure that my curtains or my blinds open just a little bit. So as the sun starts to get up, I'm gonna start to get up naturally with the sun. I find that I don't get jet lag at all. Coming home is a bit different. Whenever you come home, you always find that you get jet lag worse. And I try and do the same thing. How flight times from Europe into Brisbane don't really line up with my system as such. The flights get in at like midnight. So it kind of makes it a little bit harder, and I still find that I get jet lag on the way home, but way less than if I was to arrive at like daytime and have to keep myself awake for a whole day. My next trick to keep, to make sure you don't lose your shit, is to take food on the plane. I hate airplane food. Like, I mean, airplane food is disgusting. I don't blame them, because how can you make airplane food nice, the very notion of what airplane food is, but it's disgusting, and I need to sort of eat when I'm bored. I need something crunchy, I need something salty, something sweet, so I take my own food with me, just to make sure that I have that available. My next tip to stop you from losing your shit is clear toiletry bags. Now, I'm that person that I probably will be in a rush to get out the door just to experience the day while I'm overseas, and the last thing I want to be doing is rummaging through my toiletry bag to try and find that one product that's at the bottom that I need. So toiletry bags are great way. They're so easy. You can just look in, see where the product is that you need, get it, and it's done deal. They're easy to go. They're just gonna save you that little bit of extra time, but they're gonna save you that sanity. They're gonna save you that rush and that like, oh, where is this sort of thing, because you can see it straight away. Okay, my next tips and tricks are all about keeping yourself nice and organized. And the first one I have to show you guys is packing cells or packing pods. Now you can get these from a range of places. These are fantastic. I know that if I don't use these and I fold my clothes, or if you roll your clothes, as soon as I put my suitcase up and wheel it, all of those clothes are going to fall down to the bottom, and they're not going to be neat and tidy anymore. They're just going to be scrunched up, and they're going to stay like that for my whole travel time. If I pack my clothing or whatever in these cells, I know that as soon as, even if it inverts, the clothes aren't going to move anywhere. They're not going to get crumpled up. They're going to stay nice and packed, because they're nice and compact in this travel cell or packing pod. Now, you don't even just have to use packing pods. I know online stores like Beginning Boutique or Princess Polly, if you're in Australia, they ship their clothes in those little sort of canvas bags. If you keep those canvas bags, they're great little sort of packing pods as well. You can pack your clothes into those as well. Same sort of system, and you'll know that they won't move around in your bag when it's, you know, in transit. My next tip to keep you organized is by keeping a copy of your travel documents on your iPad or your phone or your laptop. So having a sort of soft copy. Now the way I do this is I save my documents as a PDF file and I send them to myself in my email. I have access to my email on my iPad. So I open up that PDF, and when you open up a PDF document on your iPad, you have the option to save it to your iBooks. So I just do that and I save it to my iBooks. So I know that if I just go to my iBooks app, I haven't done it yet. I need to, like, that's on my list of things to do. So I don't think I can show you what I mean. And it just means if you actually lose, if you lose the hard copies, you have a soft copy with you. My next little organizational tip are sunglasses cases. Now, using sunglasses cases, not for sunglasses. These are great little packing cells, I guess. I love using sunglasses cases just to put pens, lip balms, headphones, external chargers, all of that sort of stuff. They're great. They're nice and hard. They're nice and compact. You're not going to have your headphones rummaging through your bag or getting tangled with anything because they're in a sunglasses case, and you're not going to lose a sunglasses case in your bag. You can get funky designs, crazy designs, and you'll always be able to reach for it. So I think these are great little packing hacks, I guess. So use sunglasses cases as much as you can. Alright, my next little organizational tip is to do with charging your phone. Now, I have gotten to that point where I have just realized that my phone is on 10% battery and I need to get out the door to meet my tour group or go out for dinner in like 20 minutes time. And obviously I need to charge my phone the quickest I can. And the way I go about doing that, which is I'm sure most people of you might know, is by putting your phone on airplane mode. By putting it on airplane mode, all of your apps are going to shut off, they're just going to stop, and your phone will just focus on charging the actual phone, not powering all of the stuff that's sitting behind your phone. And you'll find that it charges so much quicker. My next little tip is again about charging your phone or your iPad or certain cameras is by using your TV or the TV in your hotel room. Now TVs these days have USB ports, so anything that can charge through a USB port like your phone or GoPros or your iPad, you can actually put the charger into the USB port of the TV and just, you don't need to turn the TV on, just have the device and the TV actually charges. So if you forget a adapter or you run out of room on your adapter, you don't have enough, you're charging something else, never fear, you can actually use a TV, and most hotel rooms come with TVs anyway, so that's a really good tip and trick as well. That's it for my travel tips and tricks. I hope you enjoyed this video. I would love to know what your tips and tricks are, so don't forget to leave them in the comments below. And if you have any questions, leave them below as well, or on any of my social media, because when I get back, I will be doing a travel related questions and answers video. So that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next one. Bye! Alright, for this episode, I'm going to be walking you guys through my favorite travel gadgets.